my name is Martha Zameda. I'm an applications engineer with Agilent Technologies focused on LTE and LTE advanced technologies. 3GPP defines two kinds of receiver tests for LTE base stations, also known as eNB. Receiver characteristics test defined in section 7, and receiver performance requirements defined in section 8 of the 3GPP 36.141 specifications. Two of the most challenging test requirements are defined under the performance requirements test, and these are the hybrid automatic repeat request, or HARQ feedback, and uplink timing adjustments, where the eNB under test sends a feedback to the test equipment, and the test equipment is required to dynamically configure uplink signals based on the HARQ and the timing adjustment feedback it gets from the eNB. What you will learn in this video is how Agilent can help meet these challenges with the new X-Series vector signal generators and its real-time capability. The signal generator can be configured for both HARQ and timing adjustment tests. The short video, however, will focus on the HARQ feedback test. In our test setup here, we have the new MXG signal generator, the LTE uplink real-time signal studio software to generate the uplink signal, and the Agilent PXA signal analyzer with 89600 VSA software to look at the dynamically changing HARQ value out of the MXG. 3GPP has defined various test configurations along with predefined signal settings for receiver testing, and these predefined configurations are called fixed reference channels, or FRCs. Signal Studio for LTE simplifies the test setup with FRC Wizard that quickly configures all of the required parameters based on the definition provided in the 3GPP specifications. As you can see here, the timing adjustment test is one of the performance requirements, as I mentioned earlier. And this requires signal generators to be able to accept feedback signal from the eNB under test, and this is where you would go to set up that particular test. The X-Series signal generator's real-time capability can accept external feedback signal received from the eNB. For our setup, we are using predefined sequence to simulate HARQ closed-loop feedback. The PXA with 89600 VSA is configured to look at the decoded uplink share channel, so we can look at the RV index, or the redundancy version, which is associated with HARQ feedback. Correctly received packets are acknowledged by the eNB, and packets with errors are requested for retransmission by the eNB. And that's what we're looking at on the VSA software. The sequence we sent to the MXG are all ACK. So all the RVs are zero, which means all data are received correctly based on the CRC. When NAC is received, the UE, or in this case, the MXG, sends the same data with different redundancy and changes the RV index. We can see on the VSA software, the RV index are all changing because now the MXG is getting all NAC and it performs retransmission. Agilent's X-Series vector signal generator and its real-time capability, as well as the real-time LTE Signal Studio software, help you perform LTE base station receiver conformance tests as required by 3GPP. For more information on Agilent's LTE solution or our new X-Series signal generators, please visit our website.